Today, we're going to continue our series on hosting a Gatsby site using AWS. In the first video, we stepped through the setting up the basic infrastructure needed to host this site. In the second video, we added the missing pieces to make it production ready. One of those pieces, including setting up a second S3 bucket in CloudFront distribution for the purpose of redirecting the root domain to the www version of the domain. Today, we're going to create a Lambda Edge function to take care of this redirect instead of the duplicate S3 bucket in CloudFront distribution. Hi, I'm Phil Sparks with Guiding Digital. AWS Lambda is a serverless compute platform at AWS that allows you to execute functions in response to events, including events from CloudFront. In today's video, we're going to create a Lambda Edge function and associate it to our CloudFront distribution so we can redirect our root domain to our www version of our domain. If you're wanting to follow along with today's demo, make sure you've watched the first video in the series. If you follow along through both videos, you'll want to update your DNS to point both the www and the root domain back to your original CloudFront instance before you continue. So let's get started. From the AWS Management Console homepage, I'll first navigate to the Lambda service. AWS requires all Lambda Edge functions to be created in the Northern Virginia region. So the first thing I'm going to do is change the region. Then I'll click the Create Function button. I'll give my function a name. I'm going to keep the default runtime of Node.js. If you want, you can use other platforms like .NET or Ruby or Python. Then we need to create the execution role. The execution role just gives the Lambda function the permissions it needs. In our case, our Lambda redirect function doesn't need to reach out to any outside resources. So really all it needs is permissions to write the logs. There are some special trust relationships you need to set up for the role. And so the easiest thing to do is just use this option that says create a new role from AWS policy templates. Then we give our role a name. And then choose the policy template of basic Lambda Edge permissions. Then we can click the Create Function button. Now we need to add our code to our function. Let's switch to Visual Studio first and review the code. I'm not a big fan of making you watch me type out my code examples during my demos. And so if you want to follow along with the demo, either pause the video and you can type it out, or I'll include a link to my Git repo with this function in the video description so you can just copy and paste the function. So let's walk through the important parts of the function. The first line I'll call out is the if statement, where we're checking to see if it starts with www. And if it doesn't, we won't do the redirect. There's really two scenarios where we want the redirect to happen. The first is if a request comes to our site for guidingdevelopers.com without the www. And the second is if for some reason a request comes to our site using the default domain that's assigned to your distribution, the CloudFront.net domain. And so this if statement will take care of both of those scenarios. The next line is our new domain that we want to forward to. In this case, it's fully qualified with www.guidingdevelopers.com. In our demo today, I just have a single site that I'm associating this Lambda Edge function to. But if you were managing multiple sites and you wanted to reuse this function across all those sites, you probably wouldn't want to hard code this. So one thing you could do is you could get the host name from the request headers.host. And if the value of the host field was your custom domain, you could just use that as your starting point. If it's a CloudFront domain, you could add a JSON file that mapped the CloudFront domain names to your custom domain name that was assigned to that distribution. The next line adds the path back to the new URL. Then the next line ensures that we have a trailing slash at the end. From a search engine perspective, pages with a slash and pages without a slash are two different things. So you want to make sure and redirect one of those versions to the other so search engines don't see it as duplicate content. Next, we add our query string back if there is a query string. This next part creates the response that will return back. You set the status code to 301. The status description doesn't really matter, just some description that makes sense to you. And then in the location object, you give the URL that you want to redirect to. Then we return the response, which returns the response back to the viewer. If the if statement had evaluated to true, meaning the user had entered the www prefix, then we would return back the original request, which would then pass it to the origin. Now let's add our code to our Lambda function. We'll switch back to the AWS console, and then we'll go down and they've got a built-in code editor, and we'll paste in our code there, and then we'll click save. And then anytime you create a new function or make a change to existing function, you need to publish a new version. Before you assign your function to your CloudFront distribution, let me show you how you can set up tests to test your function in the Lambda console. To create a test, go to the test dropdown and click the Configure Test Events link. And then you can choose from an event template. There's one for Amazon CloudFront normalized query string, and we could use this as a starting point to test our function. This represents a sample request object that would be sent by CloudFront to our Lambda Edge function. I'm going to strip it down even further and just include the attributes that we care about in our test. In this first test, we'll be testing the happy path, and we'll be testing a request with the www. So we'll give our test a name of with www. We'll create one more test. This time we'll test without the www. Now to run the test, we can go to the test menu and we'll test the with www first, and we see that the request was passed along to the origin as we expected without the redirect. Then if we test the without www and click test, we see that it returned the 301 response as expected, and the URL looks as expected as well. Now let's assign our function to our CloudFront distribution. There are two ways you can do this. The first is assigning the function directly within the CloudFront section of the console. To do this, first we'll copy the ARN. We'll need this into the next step. And then we'll switch back to CloudFront console. We'll then go into our distribution and go to the behaviors tab and modify the default one. And if you scroll down the bottom, there's a section to associate the Lambda functions. Then you have to select the CloudFront event type. CloudFront has four different types of events that allows you to assign Lambda Edge functions to. I'm not going to cover the details of each of these events in this video. I'll include a link in the video description to a AWS documentation page that describes each of these events. We're going to associate our function to the viewer request event. Functions that are assigned to this event will execute every time that CloudFront receives a request, and it executes before CloudFront checks to see if the object is in the cache, and of course before the request is forwarded on to the origin. So we'll select viewer request from the dropdown and then paste in our ARN number and then click the save button. Like any change to CloudFront, it can take between 10 and 20 minutes to fully deploy. Before we test our changes, let me show you the second method of associating your Lambda function to CloudFront. Switching back to the Lambda section of the console, after saving and publishing your new version, you can go to the Action menu and click the Deploy to Lambda Edge option. Then from that menu, choose the distribution, leave the cache behavior as the asterisk, and then choose Viewer Request as the CloudFront event, and then check the box to confirm deploy to Lambda Edge, and then click the deploy button. One odd thing about this modal is it actually doesn't close after you hit the deploy button, but you can assume that your function has been associated with the CloudFront after the form resets to its original state. And now let's test our redirect. First, let's purge our cache. To do that, go to the invalidations tab of your distribution and click on the create invalidation button. Enter /asterisk for the object pass, and then click the invalidate button to purge all the cache. Now we'll open up a new tab and go to the guidingdevelopers.com website without the www prefix. And then we see our redirect to the www version worked. Let's test one more scenario. Let's take off the www prefix again, and this time we're going to go to page 2 and then add a query string as well. When we see that worked as well, it kept the path and the query string and added the trailing slash and also the www prefix. Let's test one more scenario. Let's make sure that it redirects the default CloudFront domain. Copy that from our general tab and then replace our guidingdevelopers.com domain with the CloudFront domain. And we see that it redirects as well. So our redirect is working as expected. Today's video, I've given you another option you can use for your redirects. There are many other use cases for Lambda Edge functions, such as using them to add security headers or using them for authentication. And so I hope by showing you Lambda Edge functions, I've given you another tool you can use to customize your Gatsby sites. In future videos in our series on hosting Gatsby site in AWS, we'll go over how you can automate your code and infrastructure deployments. Thanks for watching today. If you found this video useful, give me a like and make sure to subscribe if you want more content on web best practices. Also, feel free to leave me a comment or question below and I'll try to respond to each one. Thanks.